Thanks for tuning in to this week's GH Talk. I hope you all had a great week and are having an even better weekend. I am so late with filming this video. My daughter Layla would not let me live. Just running around here like she don't have a bedtime and doing weird stuff. Like practically making out with our oven door.
Layla, stop! Ew! Ew! Stop it!
I love her so much, but she wears me down. I don't know how many of you have seen this picture on social media. I hadn't noticed at first, but Michael's cast has switched legs about 3 times now. Fans were clowning the show because not only is the writing inconsistent, but so is the character's wardrobe. GH fans learned a few days ago that August 29th, 30th, and 31st will be encore episodes instead of new ones. A fan reached out to Nathan Varney requesting an explanation. He responded with this tweet. "You shouldn't be worried. It's been planned for months. Last year, we didn't have to take additional encores because Trump interrupted the show so much. This year, with less interruptions, we needed to take some extra days off based on the number of new episodes we produce for you." Some fans aren't worried, but there are plenty who are thinking that this could lead to cancellation. "I've been watching soaps for more than 15 years, and this is a first for me. It could be that the number of episodes that they produce has gone down. However, I did give Nathan's explanation the side eye. On this week, we saw Robert, who is trying to find Anna and Finn, reach out to Jason for help." Why Jason? "I just don't think he did anything more than someone else could have done. Anna and Finn did learn that the mystery patient is Cassandra. Quick question, do we want her back or can she take a hike? I am curious to know if she does remember that Nina was the one who placed her in the coma. That's the real reason why Valentine doesn't want her to wake up and cause hella problems." Of course, he did not mention that to Robert, who was snooping around for information. Valentine also got a visit from Peter, who finally shaved, thank goodness. Peter is supposed to stay away from Nina, but that didn't last long as they ran into each other at Charlie's. I couldn't help but laugh when Peter announced that he now owns the Invader and asked Maxie if she'd like to work for him. I just wasn't expecting that. I'm glad that Peter did respond quickly to Nina because she was going off for most of the episode on Madeline. By the time she got to Peter, I was like, girl, if you don't take several damn seats and have some quiet time. Now we're back to the question of whether or not her child is alive. Many fans have believed for years that Kiki is indeed Nina's daughter. Are the writers really going to pursue this story? Because I mean, it's been on hold for quite some time. Kiki would probably be ecstatic to have anyone but Ava as her mother right now. Ava got Scotty to ask Griffin the question.
"Have you ever had sex with Kiki Jerome?"
He told the truth, and luckily it didn't cost Kiki her case against Dr. Be Creepy. It did, however, cost Griffin his job at the moment as Ava turned him in with that DNA test. Griffin doesn't know that Ava ratted him out. Kiki and Ava confronted each other. However, it was Franco's words to Ava that had me dishing him out a standing ovation.
"If Kiki and Griffin are dishing out to you a little bit of what you've been dishing out to all these people for all these years, then I say it's only a fraction of what you deserve and it's long overdue."
Ava has every right to be angry. She was lied to and her heart is broken. Yet Kiki didn't sleep with Griffin for revenge and she didn't keep having an ongoing affair with him behind her back. Ava wants vengeance and I don't believe Kiki or Griffin is worth all this energy she's given them. I never liked Ava with Griffin. Ava needs a man who doesn't flinch when he sees her for who she really is. Someone she's comfortable enough with to let it all hang out. It'd be great if Ava had a mister who was just as messy and have them go toe-to-toe with Sunny and Carly. What a shame that Ava's good person routine was solely based upon her relationship with Griffin. But that double slap she served him, my goodness.
Ava, I can explain.
Christina returned and she still doesn't know what to do with herself. She went by to visit Michael, who's burying himself with his work so he doesn't have to think about the loss of his son. It was nice of him to want the baby buried with Morgan. Unknowingly again this week, Michael held his son. The only two people who noticed the baby's striking appearance was Mike, who was then dismissed after saying the baby looked like Carly, and Julian, who remarks that Wiley looked completely different from that first night he held him. Then Alexis receives the call call we all knew was coming. The birth mom wants her baby back. It's heartbreaking when you think about it because for whatever reason, she gave her child up for adoption, possibly thinking that the child would have a better life with another couple. At some point, she's going to have to learn that her child is dead. If it were me, I would live with blame and regret for the rest of my life, probably along the lines of, my child would still be alive if I would have just kept him. Brad is going to need help keeping this secret, and it looks more and more like Julian will be the one that he'll have to turn to. I wonder if Julian will take Margot up on her offer to help take down Sonny. Kim was so turned off when he was talking about Sonny that she actually called him by his real name. Julian clearly does not want to continue being underneath Sonny's thumb, and if that means working with the DA to take him down, he just might do that. Drew turned Margot down flat, yet that didn't stop her from awkwardly kissing him. Kim also said that the DA looked familiar to her. I don't like Margot, she be looking weird. Although I'm curious to know if she does have some type of connection with Drew from the past. Plus, Sam and Jason pointed out that her grudge against Sonny is personal. Does anyone else think that it probably has something to do with that dead body under Charlie's? Jason and Sam's exchange about Danny wanting to bring home a pig was cute.
You know, I hear they make good pets.
Straight to your place.
Too bad Curtis wasn't having as nice a time since Stella overheard Jordan telling him to uninvite her to the wedding. I'm with Jordan 100% on this. Stella can be a bitter bitch at home. Bye. Liz had to deal with Cameron, who shoplifted. He even went off on Franco.
I don't have to listen to you. You're not my father.
Cameron sounded like a spoiled brat compared to Jocelyn when she was confronted by her mother. Apparently, Elizabeth thinks her son is perfect and incapable of stealing, so of course Jocelyn had to be the one to get him to do it. Thankfully, Carly was swift with the clapback.
Must be painful that your mom can't even see you, except as a reflection of herself.
Carly and Jocelyn's relationship is awesome, and Carly was just fantastic with how she approached the conversation by reminding Jocelyn of how important the truth is.
And if I find out down the road that you're not being honest with me, that's gonna put us in a hole that's gonna be really tough to dig our way out.
That girl was gearing up to laugh. The mother-daughter scenes were very touching, but my favorite was between Sonny and Mike when Sonny made the sign for Mike to help him find his room. Those are just a few of my thoughts on this week's moments. Are you team Ava or are you team Kiki? Do you think Ava is wasting her time with her revenge against them? Cause I sure as hell do.
I will have it!
Girl, they are not worth it. Will Julian end up working with Margot to take Sonny down? Can Sonny be taken down? No. If Nina's child is alive, should it be Kiki or someone new? And do you think GH taking a 3-day break is a cause for concern? As always, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, GHers, take care.